Anybody going back home to a different country?
Yeah.
I'm glad. Good evening. I'm James Henningsen, president of the College of Central Florida. First, can you all give me a big round of applause for our Sounds of Scotland pipe and drum band? Thank you for that. It's a great honor for us to have him here and joining us. Now it's my great pleasure to introduce Ainsley Harker, a member of our CF Patriot Singers, who will sing our national anthem.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
You may be seated. Let's give Ainsley one more round of applause. She did a fantastic job in front of all of you today. Thank you. Welcome, distinguished members of the College of Central Florida faculty, District Board of Trustees, faculty members and friends, community members, and members of the graduating class to the fall 2021 commencement of the College of Central Florida. At CF, we take great pride in knowing that we have helped generations find and succeed in their educational and career goals. Today, we focus on you, our students, who have completed requirements for certificates and associate and baccalaureate degrees. We recognize you for what you have achieved, especially during this challenging time in our history. And we encourage you to continue to pursue your dreams. It's my pleasure to introduce our platform guests. As I introduce each guest, I ask that they remain standing and that you hold your applause until the end. Representing our students is Ms. Madison Estes, president of the Citrus Campus Student Activities Board. Representing the Career Professional Employees Council is Ms. Lois Kohlweiss. Representing the faculty is Dr. Pete Nicely. Our student speaker, Mr. Edgar Soto, one of our outstanding graduates. Dr. Mark Paugh, Vice President for Academic Affairs. Dan Andrews, son of Ms. Carolyn Grissom, our Distinguished Service Award recipient. Mr. Bill Edgar, Chair of the District Board of Trustees. Ms. Joyce Brancato from the District Board of Trustees. And Mr. Bobby Durrance from the District Board of Trustees. Please join me in giving these dedicated individuals a nice round of applause. Thank you. We have so much to celebrate tonight. Graduates, today is truly your day. So enjoy your walk across stage as you have earned it. Today's graduates here today represent nearly 1,600 certificate and degrees earned in the summer and fall semesters. Congratulations to all of you. The credentials include over 700 college credit certificates in business, criminal justice, emergency medical technician, engineering, and other programs. Our students who graduate with a certificate earn about $15,000 more annually than the average high school graduate. Another 184 of our graduates this fall have earned their associate in science in programs such as accounting, business administration, engineering technology, equine, information technology, and others. As associate in science graduates, they will enter the workforce with an average salary of approximately $52,000. More than 500 of our graduates have earned their associate in arts, and many will continue their education in a bachelor's degree program right here at CF. Many others will transfer to the University of Florida, University of Central Florida, University of South Florida, and other four-year colleges and universities across the country. Our AA graduates consistently perform as well, if not better, than students who begin their education at a university, a tribute to the hard work and the quality of our faculty and staff. And another 122 of our graduates this evening have earned one of our bachelor's degrees in business and organizational management, education, or nursing. You have all made an outstanding choice to invest in your education here at the College of Central Florida. I'm very proud to announce that CF was recently recognized by the Aspen Institute as one of the highest performing colleges in the nation in regard to student performance and job placement measures. It is the fifth time in recent years that CF has been named among the top colleges in the nation. Great tribute and dedication with our faculty and staff, so thank you for that recognition. As president, this is the point in the ceremony where I get to make some personal remarks and congratulate a few of our outstanding graduates. First, I'd like to recognize our award-winning faculty and staff who are truly dedicated to your success. Would all members of the faculty and staff please stand? Earlier this week, we lost a beloved professor, Darryl Riley, who taught history at the college for more than 15 years. We will miss Professor Riley, and I know that if he were here with us today, he would be so proud of you and would join with all faculty to share in the joy of your accomplishments. He was so dedicated, he was even working right up until the end from his hospital bed, teaching classes this fall semester. So could we give him a round of applause, please? Thank you. Now I'd like to recognize the family and friends of our graduates. Only you know what it took to get your graduate here today. Graduates, would you please stand and express your appreciation to your family and friends for their support? I would also like to recognize the CF Foundation and our donors for providing over $3.9 million in scholarship support and resources to our students this year. Thanks to our affordability and scholarship resources from our foundation, 76% of our graduates leave the college with zero student loan debt. There you go. And now I'd like to share the stories of a few graduates who have taken different paths in their education and careers. The first graduate I'd like to recognize is Charlene Jablonski, who has earned a Bachelor of Applied Science in Business and Organizational Management with an accounting specialization. Charlene served in the Army before beginning a 16-year career with Childhood Development Services. She was about to give birth to her third child when she learned that she would be laid off from her job because of funding cuts. Charlene, who had not graduated from high school, recognized the big life change as an opportunity for a new career. She enrolled at CF and said she was terrified at starting college at 40 years of age, but wanted to be an example for her children. She never thought she would attend college, and today she is thankful for embracing the opportunity to do something outside of her comfort zone and proving that she could be successful. Congratulations, Charlene, for setting an example for your children and for all of our students. Charlene, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. The next graduate I would like to recognize is Michael Gage Kamara, who has earned an Associate Science in Agribusiness Management. Michael attended the Academy of Environmental Science in Crystal River and became interested in agriculture while attending Crystal River High School. Through his high school years, he studied aquaponics, showed swine and steer in county fair, and got his first job at a hay farm. Michael said CF's Vintage Farm campus provides lots of opportunity for hands-on learning, and he is looking forward to owning his own farm one day. He just accepted a job with a livestock company, Fenco Farms, which specializes in producing livestock with high-quality genetics. And it has encouraged him to continue his education to become a large animal vet, which he says is a great need in Citrus County. Congratulations, Michael. Would you stand and be recognized? Great job. The next graduate I would like to recognize is Essence Elissa Taylor, who has earned an Associate in Arts degree. After graduating from Vanguard High School, Essence had what she describes as a rough start. She tried a few jobs while attending classes at CF and then contracted COVID. She has had some lingering effects, but persevered to earn her degree. She said her spiritual life is what brought her through, and she gives God the praise. Essence was inspired by her mother, who works with individuals with disabilities, and she will continue her education with a degree in social work. Her goal is to help people who are experiencing difficulties in their lives. Congratulations, Essence Taylor. We know that you will be successful in helping others. So Essence, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. The next graduate I'd like to recognize is Eric Zimmer, who graduates with his Associate in Arts. Eric served 21 years in the U.S. Army, including 5 deployments in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Kuwait. He's also the proud father of 3 beautiful daughters, who he has encouraged to focus on their schoolwork because it leads to good things in life, and it certainly does. About 4 years ago, his girls questioned him about the value of education when he was doing fine with a high school education. So he enrolled at CF to set an example. A work-study job in the Veterans Office at CF ignited a passion for helping fellow veterans, and he returned to college after deployment to Kuwait to finish his degree. With his associate degree, he became eligible for a full-time position and was recently hired as a veteran service specialist right here at CF. And he plans to continue with a bachelor's degree to bring better services to fellow veterans. Congratulations, Eric. You have demonstrated that education does indeed lead to good things in life. And thank you for your service. Eric Zimmer, would you please stand and be recognized? The next graduate that I would like to recognize is Jessica Gonzalez. Jessica graduated from North Marion High School and immediately entered the restaurant business, thinking she would work for a year. But the year turned into 5, and she met the man who would become her husband. When they married, she gained an instant family with his 3 children, and started taking classes at CF about the same time. She said that maintaining a business, a job, and homeschooling three children for a year and a half due to COVID, all while earning two degrees, tested her strength. And yet she maintained Phi Theta Kappa membership and recognition on the Dean's List and President's List. She initially chose physical therapist assistant as an academic pathway, but was intrigued by the field of law when she took a class with Dr. Carol Smith. Today, Jessica graduates with an Associate in Science in Paralegal Studies and a Bachelor of Applied Science in Business and Organizational Management. She worked with a local government organization while finishing up classes and has already started her own bookkeeping and consulting business, Prowse Management Group. Congratulations, Jessica, and keep up the great work. Jessica Gonzalez, would you please stand and be recognized? Next up, we have the Distinguished Service Award, and it's time to present that award. It's a great honor for us here at CF to present the Distinguished Service Award to Mrs. Carolyn Barton Grissom, who left a legacy to our community before passing away in August at the age of 83. Carolyn Grissom loved children and believed in the power of education. She was born in Williston in Levy County and lived more than 60 years in Ocala, impacting countless families as an elementary school teacher. After teaching at Wyomena Park, 8th Street, and Ward's Highland Elementary, Carolyn retired in 1984 and married Julian Grissom. The couple supported many College of Central Florida programs and events through the years. Carolyn once said, "Education opens so many doors for people. It is, of course, a way to prepare for a career, to support your household, but it's also a resource to shape who we become as people." The Grissoms established the Julian C. and Carolyn Barton Grissom Endowed Scholarship, and after Julian's passing in 2007, Carolyn continued her legacy of generosity. She gifted funds to construct classrooms at the Jack Wilkinson Levy campus and the CF Vintage Farm campus. She also endowed three scholarships for taking elementary promising students to CF to provide annual scholarships to fifth grade students. We like to get them excited about college early. Carolyn will be remembered for her wonderful stories and her famous garden. But most of all, she will be remembered for her remarkable skill in helping others grow as people. It's a great honor for us today to present the Distinguished Service Award posthumously to Mrs. Carolyn Barton Grissom. And accepting that award today on her behalf is her son, Dan Andrews. Dan, could you join me up here?
I am not a commencement speaker, so I'm not going to lengthen your stay here tonight. I just want to say how proud I am to be the son of Carolyn. My brother, our wives, join us here as well. But she was a wonderful person. She was our mom. She was a teacher, and as a teacher, she cared very much about her students, and as a teacher and mother, she took many opportunities to lecture us. We had to sit carefully and attentively and listen, but she was also a great example to us, and I am most thankful for that because she taught us responsibility, good citizenship, and a love of learning. And I'm glad to be here tonight with you, and I want to thank you for recognizing our mother tonight, and I bid you great success in the future. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, we're going to try that and see how that one works. So you can hear me in the back? All right. As we've all learned to do over this year, we just pivot a little bit. All right, we've got a big treat for you coming up now. It's time to introduce our commencement speaker. Edgar Soto graduates today with his Associate in Arts. During his time at CF, Edgar has been a member of the Brain Bowl and forensics teams, which have allowed him to explore his interest in history. Edgar will continue his education at the University of Central Florida in 2022. I think you'll be inspired by his story. Please join me in welcoming your commencement speaker, Edgar Soto.
First, I'd like to thank President Henningsen, the administration, and everyone at CF for allowing me to have the opportunity to come up here and speak today. Speaking at this ceremony was the last thing to cross my mind, so I'm both humbled and honored to be up here. Second, I'd like to thank my family. I would not be up here giving this speech right now if it weren't for them, so again, I extend a huge thank you to my family. William Shakespeare once said, "It is not in the stars to hold our destiny, but in ourselves." The first message I want to convey to everyone is this: we are the architects of our own destiny. Every single one of us here has a destiny. Whatever that destiny is up for us to decide. Getting to this point has been a journey in which I've questioned what my destiny is. For a significant portion of my life, I've struggled with mental illness, namely depression and anxiety. But through perseverance and support from those around me, I've triumphed over my challenges. At the end... At the end of 2017, I dropped out of college for various reasons. I felt defeated and disillusioned. Frankly, I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. During the 3 years I spent away from college, I was at my lowest. It could be said that I wasted 3 years of my life, but I don't look at it that way. Everything that happened during those 3 years made me a better person. There were many critical junctures along the way where I could have taken a different course. However, I had a vision in mind of what I wanted my life to look like, and I took the necessary steps to will that vision into reality. Some steps I took included thinking deeply about my life and planning and setting goals for myself and methods of achieving those goals. This is what it means to be an architect of one's own destiny. The second message I would like to convey is live life according to a higher purpose. Now, this is a message that can be either secular or religious. I'm a history major, and I've noticed that the world's great historical figures, both good and evil, operated with a higher goal in mind, whether that be national self-determination or liberation from oppression or simply personal advancement. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "A man who does not have something for which he is willing to die is not fit to live." Ask yourself these questions. Why did you decide to go to college in the first place? Why do you bother waking up for those 8 a.m. classes? Answering those questions with something related to money is not a satisfactory answer. I encourage you to do some deep thinking and soul searching tonight about what your higher purpose means. The Japanese have a concept called ikigai. Ikigai can be described as the balance that is found when your talents and passions intersect with things that the world needs and is willing to pay for. Try to find your ikigai. During my short 23 years of life, I've had numerous aspirations. Perhaps the most realistic aspiration I had was being a soldier. Military service is a part of my family's history. Both my father and stepfather served more than 20 years in the Army, and I currently have cousins who are still serving. To make a long story short, I found out during my senior year of high school that I wasn't able to join the Army for medical reasons. I was crushed. Since then, I could say I spent a lot of time just throwing things at the wall and seeing what stuck career-wise. One thing I've always been passionate about is history. I'm one of those people who will sit and read long history books for fun. My family and close friends can attest to that. I'm either doing that or I'm watching historical documentaries on YouTube or Netflix. I got to the point where I decided to go all in and become a history professor. Three things were going through my mind at that important point in my life. First, I have nothing to lose by making this decision. Second, I thought it would be best to pursue this goal and fail rather than not take that chance and regret it later. Lastly, I wanted to live a fulfilling life where I get to share my love of history with others. If you had to have a Cliff's Notes version of this speech, I would break this speech down into two sentences. First, we are the architects of our own destiny. Second, live life according to a higher purpose. I'm going to leave you all with one last quote. Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius said, "What we do in life echoes in eternity." Thank you.
Thank you, Edgar, and congratulations, and thank you for your inspiring words, and we wish you all the best in your future endeavors. President Henningsen, on behalf of the faculty of the College of Central Florida, I am proud to present to you the candidates for baccalaureate and associate degrees and certificates. Each candidate has completed the requirements for the degree or certificate for which he or she is a candidate. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend that the appropriate degree or certificate be conferred. Would all the candidates please rise?
Y'all ready? All right. As president of the College of Central Florida, upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority vested in me by the state of Florida and the District Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon each of you the baccalaureate degree, associate degree, or certificate for which you have been recommended as evidence that you have fulfilled all requirements thereof, and that you are entitled to all rights and privileges pertaining to that degree or certificate. To all members of the graduating class, as a gesture in recognition of having received your degree or certificate, you may now move your tassels to the left side of your cap. Congratulations. Presentation of diplomas and certificates.
Braden Andrew Major, cum laude. Edwin Joseph, cum laude. Macy Shaylin Danata, magna cum laude. Edgar Giovanni Soto. Nicole M. Leafblad, cum laude. Mark Anthony Armstrong. Christopher M. Gibson, magna cum laude. Arlene Benbow McCoy, cum laude. Melissa Lorena Bauer, cum laude. Bailey Ann Johnson, magna cum laude. Jessica Lynn Gonzalez, cum laude. Lizbeth Ordonez Gaspar, cum laude. Farana Sukro, magna cum laude. Padeja Aliyah, cum laude. Cody W. Childers, cum laude. Daniel Christopher Johnson, cum laude. Teresa A. Benson. Jessica Seeley. Kaylin Waddle, cum laude. Patience Marie Moxley, cum laude. Denise Natasha Brown, cum laude. Alexandria Anastasia Allen, magna cum laude. Amina Christina Jimenez, magna cum laude. Amanda Karen Bouchard, magna cum laude. Alexandria May Boucher, cum laude. Danielle Renee Kennard, magna cum laude. Justin Time McDonald, magna cum laude. Claudia Rojo Lugo, cum laude. Lauren V. Sanchez, cum laude. Veronica Tumenia, cum laude. Migdali Josefina Sarah Nessie, cum laude. Taylor M. Powell, magna cum laude. Douglas Allen Isom, cum laude. Georgiana Renee Kosak, magna cum laude. Cassandra Marie Louise Hughes. Ashton Nicole Lloyd, magna cum laude. Candace Allen, cum laude. Charlene Ann Jablonski, summa cum laude. Kevin L. Gamble, cum laude. Shaylin Marie Levy, magna cum laude. Isaac Obed Fonseca Syria, magna cum laude. Brianna Gabrielle Sermons, cum laude. Valerie Megan Carroll, magna cum laude. Ashley Luciano, cum laude. Robert Stephen Egan, magna cum laude. Sinai Trone Henderson, cum laude. Kelly Elizabeth Dennison, magna cum laude. Sierra S. Oliver, cum laude. Willie Leonard Curry, cum laude. Mark Christian Ashbaugh. John Alexander Lorenzo. Glamel Rosa Davis. Ginger Grace Fink. Johan Manuel Pinellas. Haley Brannon. Christina M. Baer. Veronica Martinez. Liliana Cervantes. Raquel Toriala. Samantha May Roberts, cum laude. Catherine Sarah Owens, cum laude. Clarissa Victoria Cotton, magna cum laude. Landon Riley Tucker, cum laude. Rakendra Shanae Powell, summa cum laude. Antoinette Natasha St. Martin, summa cum laude. Kenneth Witkowitz, summa cum laude. Gabriella Witkowitz, summa cum laude. Erica Elise Smith, summa cum laude. Anthony William Pinella II, cum laude. Andrew Deshaun Shack. Paul James Cracchiolo. Jennifer Lynn Alfonso, cum laude. Christopher Francis Bernacki, summa cum laude. Audra Guideen, summa cum laude. Riley Paige Gonzalez, cum laude. Sydney Keller, cum laude. Jason Arthur Griffiths, summa cum laude. Trent O'Neill Robinson, magna cum laude. Lori McDonald, cum laude. Sarah Darlene Peace, magna cum laude. Laurel Kirsten LeCarum, cum laude. Dana Christine Huff, cum laude. Chardé Aki Patrick, magna cum laude. Alina J. Christian, magna cum laude. Gabriel Enrique Funes, cum laude. Isaiah Deanda Delgado, magna cum laude. Tiffany Lee McDonald, cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Wilburn, cum laude. Madison Paula Tramia, magna cum laude. Rachel Grace Herman, summa cum laude. Michael Gage Kamara, summa cum laude. Anthony Solomon, cum laude. Brinigan Florence Green, summa cum laude. Sky Marie Wickham, cum laude. Cassidy Paige Snyder, magna cum laude. Tanya Teresa Pierpont, magna cum laude. Jake Liam Rowland, magna cum laude. Satara Ann Lockley. Aida Sagaliva Decker. Kyla Eva Marie Morrison. Taylor Shea Falabella. Kaylee Ann Frederick, magna cum laude. Heather D. Strickland, summa cum laude. Misty Lynn Helfer, cum laude. Harley Jane Phelps. Jessica Paige Perez. Michael Andrew St. Hilaire, cum laude. Abigail Arena Brown, magna cum laude. Emma Leanna M. Langston, magna cum laude. Rachel Brianna Murphy, cum laude. Shelby Lynn Richardson, summa cum laude. Kylie May DePrimo, magna cum laude. Colin Patrick Hanna, summa cum laude. Dewi Chi Pham, magna cum laude. Melanie Jane Negron, magna cum laude. Tasha Ann Hetrick, cum laude. Janae Ann Baker, cum laude. Michaela Zoya Johnson, cum laude. Hannah Megan Waugh, cum laude. Ashley Marie Stevens, cum laude. Destiny Inaton Ramirez Savage, cum laude. Jessica Marie Lene Pister, summa cum laude. Kayla Lynn Lewis, cum laude. Isabella Honorado Schifferstein, summa cum laude. Aniston Brooke Arvin, summa cum laude. Mona Lisa Francois, cum laude. Wendy D. Wright. Doriez Kylia Goodson. Jamari Imoni Magwood. Victoria Caitlin Castillo. Fanny Elizabeth Rodriguez. Farah Friend. Leslie Thalia Lopez. Michelle Renee Russell, summa cum laude. Tabitha Kelly Sola. Blake Tanner Dunning, magna cum laude. Jennifer Nicole Robles, magna cum laude. Abigail Michelle Sauter, cum laude. Callie Michelle Sauter, magna cum laude. Rebecca Lynn Feinberg, summa cum laude. Genesis Vega Martinez. Melina Jolie Brown, cum laude. Giselle Bustos, summa cum laude. Natalie Grace Retz, magna cum laude. Christina May Gonzalez. Sydney Adania Stout, cum laude. Shane A. Jacobs, cum laude. Troy Anthony Campo. Jacob Dean Smoot, cum laude. Sydney Ann Jurwitz, cum laude. Brooke Lynn Gunto. Catherine Faye White. Colt Cullison Mansfield. Samuel Jordan Guess. Faith Moxley. Kristen Bailey. Raina Lynn Casillas. Natalie Darlene Henderson. Elena Haven Knapp. Christina Lynn Van Cees. Taylor Renee Williams. Gabriella Echeverria. Kaylee Nicole Taylor, cum laude. Larissa Ann Mary Weinbrenner. Ariana Brooke Seguin. Megan Brianne Mazzito. Grayson Hadley Sutter, cum laude. Angelica Denise Canaria. Lindsay M. Brandline. Ashlyn Grace Hall, magna cum laude. Desiree Monica Osby Seaton. Julia Brielle Farrell, summa cum laude. Emily Lane Ferguson, summa cum laude. Melina Atha Louisa Martin, magna cum laude. Elton Simon Oliver, magna cum laude. Hello, Barrows McArfin, magna cum laude. David E. Dodge, magna cum laude. Derek Norman, magna cum laude. Ariel Chanel II, magna cum laude. Melinda Chamness, cum laude. Brandon Marin Medrano, summa cum laude. Lacey Michelle Moses, cum laude. Rosalie Cortez Lopez. Catherine Grace Wilson, magna cum laude. Melissa Krett, summa cum laude. Haley Ariel DeCille. Elizabeth Ray Cusick. Tanya Beatrice Davila Ortega, cum laude. Mary Angie Rodriguez. Essence Ulyssa Taylor. Rachel Lovely. Métis Perina Paz Morales. Yaskira Valeska Zambrano. Ramona Lee Orr. Keely Dawn Peacecheck. Yenisi Elena Rodriguez. Alejandra Gabriela Lopez Medina. Ganesh Terry McCarron. Taffin L. Anderson. Brandon Albert Watson. Priya Nirvana Langer. Arturo Ulysses Trejo Antonio. Melissa Marie Strickland. Selena May Smith. Lauren Taylor Smith. Crystal Marilyn Vanderford. Juliette Gray de Peralta. Sarah K. Greer. Samantha E. Tavernier. Kimberly A. Boggs. Marina Teresa Johnson. Doris S. Class. Valerie Rivera. Aaron Renee Carr. Hope Joy Renee Armstrong. Peyton Aubrey Fells. Chelsea Lorraine Wright. Ashley Alyssa Fry. Jessica May Hickman. Faith Desiree Reno. Kentrell Denise Roberts. Heather Patricia Breeden, cum laude. Michaela Sierra Davis, cum laude. April Ron Martinez Bonifacio, magna cum laude. Melissa Lynn Adnani, magna cum laude. Clint Michael Adams. Deedon Ifada Victor. Eric Alexander Weaver. Milagros Anton de Los Angeles Trujillo Aon. Alexis Janira Rivera. Fabiola Ivanka Morel. Tanisha Diana Cook. Janae A. Palmer. Eric P. Zimmer. Solomon Cortez Makeda. Kelsey Noel Grimes. And Christine D'Amore. Patience Rose Zimke, magna cum laude. Crystal Elizabeth Simon, cum laude. Kelly Crow. Juan David Arias Rios, magna cum laude. Lance Kelsey McCall, magna cum laude. Adriana Leanne Milton. Zakiya Chambree Collins. Jonathan A. Tyndall. Xavier Jason Moore, cum laude. Jed Elmer Arsenal, summa cum laude. Kayla Adams. Shamika Johnson Bell.
Please join me again in congratulating our graduates. Our sincere appreciation again to our narrators who had the toughest job this evening, Professor Richard Kirk and Dr. Alan Danoff, and our interpreter, Ms. Deborah Flagg. Mr. Edgar Soto, our commencement speaker. A very special thank you to the Sounds of Scotland Pipe and Drum Band and Ms. Ainsley Harker, who sang our national anthem. our CF ambassadors, friends of the foundation, members of Phi Theta Kappa, and the Student Activities Board who served as ushers, the countless staff members who worked behind the scenes to make this a memorable event. Thank you to the World Equestrian Center team for hosting us, and finally, thank you to everyone here for participating. Many congratulations to CF's newest graduates. Gimlet. As alumni, I hope you will stay connected with the college through the CF Alumni Association. As you leave tonight, I encourage you to be the leader who sets out to make a difference. Mahatma Gandhi said, "Be the change you wish to see in the world." While you make great strides to create a positive impact, the College of Central Florida will be here to help you as you help yourself and others succeed. Thank you for being here. As a tribute to our graduates, we ask you to please stand for the recessional and remain at your seats until the graduates have exited. Thank you very much.
was going to say, because she wasn't with us when we came.
So, and it's just a professional thing.